What's going on, everybody? To save you from having to watch a full feature-length film instead of making it an hour and a half, I only made it an hour and 20 minutes. Huh? Getting better. Now, it's kind of hard to break this one up. Another one of those things where keep the flow of the story going. We're doing Kasumi's loyalty mission. Figured we'd just go ahead and put it all together, and then there's a few bonus missions on the tail end of this, too. Trip to the Citadel, some stuff like that. Tying up loose ends, and then we'll get back to building our team. Go recruit somebody else.
Looking good, Miss Allison Gunn. Hock won't be able to keep his eyes off you.
I assume Allison Gunn is my cover?
You run a small but talented band of mercs out in the Terminus systems. Precisely the type of person Hock respects. I took the liberty of giving you a reputation. Papers, witnesses, article in Badass Weekly. Just don't start talking business with him, and you'll be fine.
Remind me, what kind of man are we dealing with?
Hawk's a weapons dealer and smuggler. He killed my partner and stole his Greybox. Other than that, he's not so bad. Rich, charismatic, willing to crack open a man's skull to get at the neural implants inside.
Take it I'm wearing this getup for a reason?
You'd look really out of place at a society party in armor, don't you think? You look great. You should wear this stuff more often.
Now's probably a good time to fill me in on the details.
You have been waiting patiently. Our friend, Hock, is throwing a party for his closest friends. A couple dozen of the worst liars, cheaters, and mass murderers you'll ever want to meet. All bringing gifts as a tribute to the man himself. Our tribute is a lovely statue of your old friend Saren, rendered with loving detail and filled to the brim with our weapons and armor. You can keep your pistol as long as it's concealed. They won't hassle you over a sidearm. Once inside, we'll make our way to Hawk's vault door, somewhere in the back of the ballroom. Then, we case the security and start peeling away the layers. The statue should be there, waiting for you to crack it open and arm up. Then we just waltz into the vault and take back Keiji's Greybox. And I'll finally get a chance to say goodbye.
You've worked really hard on this. Keiji must have meant a lot to you.
Was I that obvious? Keiji's Greybox holds a lot of priceless personal memories. It's all that remains of who he was. But the secret he discovered is dangerous. I wouldn't bring you here if it wasn't.
What's in the Greybox that makes it worth all this trouble?
The Greybox holds Keiji's memories. Everything from all the codes and plans he stole to all the time we spent together. Wrapped up in those memories is the secret he stole. Keiji never told me what it was, but the information got him killed.
This ought to be interesting.
That's what I'm going for. This is our stop. After you, Ms. Gunn.
Hold a moment, ma'am. There seems to be an issue with the statue.
Is there a problem here?
No, Mr. Hock. Just doing a scan.
I don't believe we've met. Donovan Hock.
Allison Gunn. A pleasure.
Sir, the scanners aren't picking anything up.
I don't think our guests would come all the way here from Ilium just to cause trouble. Do you? You may pass through, Ms. Gunn. You were invited after all. But I will ask your companion to remain outside. You understand, I hope.
If it makes you feel more secure, she can wait outside.
Good to see we're not going to have a problem. Enjoy the party.
Well, that didn't go as I expected.
Any idea why he'd send you away?
No. We've never seen each other in person, and no one knows what I look like. Just watching his ass, I'm sure. I can't blame him.
Don't worry about it. I can handle it from here.
That's good, because you'll have to do all the talking. I'll stay out of sight and stick with you the best I can. We'll keep radio contact in case something goes wrong. We need to find the door and case the security. We'll figure out the next step then.
This is an awesome change to the gameplay. I love the artwork here, too, by the way, but it's,
How did you ever contain that?
We get to investigate.
Oh, that? A quick application of force, a little pressure, and bam! Done.
Thank goodness. I thought those rabble would dog you for years.
The dress looks fine on my Shepard, but, her walk could use a little work. She kind of walks like an angry dude. I know it's because of all the surgeries and implants and the fact that, well, she was just dead a few minutes ago, but
I hear he's dead. Or
still.
Gone or something. Good riddance, I say.
All right, so we have a collection of the worst here. We could just set a nuke off in this place for all I care.
Very nice. There's more here than I expected. Password-protected voice lock, kinetic barrier, DNA scanner. Looks like an EX-700 series. Everything a vault needs to be impenetrable.
This gonna be a problem?
Please, remember who you're talking to. We'll need to get a voice sample for the voice lock. You'll have to go chat up Hock for that. We'll have to find a password too. DNA, child's play. We should find plenty of DNA samples in Hawk's private quarters. And the barrier? Cut the power. Never fails. If we can find it. Keiji could get through a system like this in his sleep. And I'm better. Let's get to it.
So I guess she chose a statue of Saren because that's something these thugs would respect. One of the greatest traitors and murderers in the history of this cycle of the galaxy or something.
It looks like the barrier's power cable runs under the floor here. I'll set your Omni tool to scan for electromagnetic fields.
Yeah, fancy clothes and refined tastes and nice paintings and beautiful house and all that doesn't make a man worth any more than what he is. This dude is as much a piece of crap as some street thug who does drive-bys. No different.
One sec. That should take care of the barrier.
All right, there's a couple ways to do this. Have some fun with this. Don't mind looking around here. Look at that. Look at that view. Man. I gotta point out, you can see where the people from Destiny got some of their ideas. I'm just saying.
Chief Rowe, huh? She sounds like a hard ass. If we could tap in.
I hear Mr. Hawk's vault is exquisite.
Who could know? He never lets anyone near it.
Okay, we're gonna have to get out to those private quarters. There's two ways. You can go through that door right there. Or we can sneak in through the outside. Outside's a little more fun, I think. Talk to him later. I guess we should,
Some sake.
That door goes to a security room. I'll take care of the lock.
Yeah, we'll there we go. Deal with the security first.
Ready when you are.
Well, I hope that other door closed behind us.
We're
about to have a shootout here. They know we're not supposed to be here. Ouch. Got him.
See what you can find.
Oh, found that. I guess it's a nice place. I guess we should find some pretty hefty chunks of credits here.
caught something?
The password is Perugia.
Huh. That's the name of the man who stole the Mona Lisa. Nice. I tapped into their communications. Maybe it'll come in handy. We still need that voice sample from Hock.
See that cartoon on the screen? An angry Krogan? Guess they're watching an action movie or something? I don't know. Alright, so we got the password. We still have to get a voice sample from this guy.
There he is. All you need to do is keep him talking long enough for me to get a voice print. Pull out the charm on this one, Shep. Whenever you're ready. After you.
Ms. Gunn, good to see you. That scene at the door hasn't soured your evening, I hope.
There's always someone gunning for people like you and me.
Yes, that's true. I'm glad you understand.
Frankly, I'm surprised your security isn't tighter. It's a ballsy move opening your front door like this.
Yes, I suppose it is. Hopefully it sends the message that I don't fear anyone stupid enough to step up to me. People these days want comfort, entertainment, love. They don't see that the galaxy is fragile. They only have to worry about simple luxuries. Why? Because people like me, and you, are doing the terrible things that keep the galaxy spinning. This party is for us. The cleaners. The support structure for the galaxy's gleeful delusions of peace. May there always be a market for the things we do.
Get him talking, and you got him talking. We've got enough of a voice sample. Let him go.
Enjoy the party, Miss Gunn.
Let's go crack that voice scanner.
Noticing on the backs of a lot of their dress clothes, they have an eclipse-like symbol. Sorta. And there's eclipse marks here all over the place. I wonder if this is the head of all the eclipse, like their particular mafia boss, like, you know, Dawn or something, whatever you want to call him. Wonder if he's that type of character. I mean, he's obviously mover and shaker of a lot of bad stuff, but the ripple effect of this guy's actions. This is good. Watch this. I'm fixing to be sneaky here. Gotta love playing an infiltrator.
Someone's coming.
Hello. It's a whole lot funner when it's really bad people that you're pushing off the ledges. Look, dude. Take that. Really? I'm so gonna kill you more than I was gonna kill you already. Or whatever. Yeah, we could have gone a different route. We could have talked the door guard into letting us in. Basically, once you find out who the security chief's name is, and then
for anything we can get usable DNA from, just make it quick and quiet.
And then you deal with the security. You can.
It's clean.
It's like pass a speech check or something. Anyway.
Found a sample?
No, a credit check.
I found one credit.
No skin flakes.
The housekeepers must be thorough.
Hey, I'm not above searching for quarters in the couch, man. $7,800, nice.
The cleaners don't dare touch treasures like this. We can get some skin cells from the dust. It's probably contaminated, though. We should find another sample. No DNA, but... looks like Hawk's been trying to crack Keiji's Greybox. Looks like he's missing something. He hasn't cracked the encryption yet.
Holographic interface. We'll find a sample here.
We can probably get Hawk's DNA off the datapad. He seems to have obsessed over this. But I'm not sure there's enough. Let's keep looking. Empty. Too bad. A cigarette butt would have been a good source.
A
Not a great saliva sample, but it's still useful. That should do it. Let's get out of here.
Okay, I think we have pretty much all we need. Right? Disabled the power. Got some DNA samples. Got his voice sample. Have the password.
Someone got through on the balcony. How the hell did they do that? I don't know. Jump down, shut the guards, broke the window. You didn't hear someone breaking a window? No gunshots?
They were even talking about it. You didn't hear that? You didn't hear any of that? I'm busting up all this dude's artwork, too. Oh, nice.
We're done here.
Man, she's such a little ninja, and she's got the best armor in the game. Man, I love her outfit. Oh, it was nothing. Just crickets. Yeah, in the other room. That's all. That's all it was. See, what if I was to live in this universe? I'd love a house like this. Oh, this is just too much house for one person, in my opinion. But nice. It's really cool the way they laid it out. It looks like a ridiculously wealthy person's house.
That got it. The barrier's down. I'll check for security cams. Go ahead and get dressed.
Go get her Greybox back, right?
So this is Hawk's vault. Very nice. This scanner will hone in on the Greybox. It's not far.
Look at some of this guy's stuff. While we're down here,
I could still get money for something like this, even outside the Alliance. Asari go nuts for this sort of thing. How did Hock get Lady Liberty's head? Damn you, Hock! A model of the Kara. It's like a Turian Titanic, the way I hear it.
Look at this, an ogre from Dragon Age.
Imagine that thing coming at you in a dark alley. This is nice. Oddly relaxing.
I don't think there's any safes in this room.
Hawk has good taste. I'll give him that. Michelangelo's David. Just... wow. Think we could get this out through the door? Everything's valuable to someone. Doesn't look like much, but that might be one of the most valuable pieces here. Turian art is rare outside of Palavin. For good reason, I say.
We saw a lot of things similar to that in Mass Effect 1 on the planets. Looks like quarry stuff.
Wow. This has got to be old. When was the last time? time the Quarians wrote on stone. I feel like its eyes are following me. Yikes. That's impressive. Not sure what it is, though. That's a Casa Locust. No, the Casa Locust. The gun that killed two presidents. Gorgeous. It even comes with a perfect copy, too. I'm sure Hock won't mind if we borrowed these.
We can use this.
Awesome. I love this SMG. One of my favorite guns. Automatically get to use it, too.
Oh, my God. There it is.
Don't bother, Miss Goldthorn. It's code-locked. I had a feeling that was you at the door. I knew if it was really you, you'd get through anyway.
You know me. I don't like to disappoint.
I need what's in your grey box, Kasumi. You know I'm willing to kill you for it. I'll admit your skills are impressive. You got into my vault like I'd left it open. But you're still going to die, screaming. No!
Have I got your attention?
That shut him up.
Kill them.
All right, I'm not fixing to play around with his entire army that he's about to send in here. No. All right, let her find some cover. Yeah, send your drones out on that, bitch. I don't care, that was fun.
That had to hurt. Checking blueprints. There's a landing pad to the east. Let's get out of here.
Joker, bring the shuttle in. Now!
Honestly, once that engineer starts throwing drones out and you get about 20 of those troopers right and left, they start flanking you, that turns into a hell of a fight. That can end really badly. But the old grenade launcher solves all those problems. I'm gonna make sure I grab everything here. She wants her gray box. She got it. And I stand to make some credits in all this. All right, she needs to go find cover. She'll charge. She's really bad about that. She gets a 5 out of 5 for courage, but yeah. I don't know. I wouldn't give her 5 out of 5 for smarts sometimes. Not in fighting. Ah, damn it. Almost. Almost. If we had Miranda here, I think that'd be a one-shot kill. She gives us that 15% bonus. And Kasumi's down anyway? Alright, well. I'll do this by myself then. Take that. It's me and you, huh, buddy? Let's get some shield breaker on here. Actually, we'll go ahead and assign that to all of our weapons while we're chilling. We got a mech shooting missiles at us. Well, let me go ahead and adjust all my gear. I'll be with you in a minute. He can't get through that door. Makes it a little easier. So I don't have to sit here and kite him around this place. Man, these things are tanky. I really want to upgrade my Reeve, too. I'm saving my points to max out my cloak, though. Cloak's got to come first, and everything else start falling into place. Honestly, I'd have liked to have done that already. But it's all good. We've been getting by. We've been doing fine. Damn it. Almost got his armor down. Okay, he's soft now. Alright, she's not getting back up, so there's still somebody up there. I'm guessing no more Big Macs, though. I guess there might be. I don't think so, though. No. You weren't hiding that good, were you? Called me a bitch! You bitch! I got him! I'm talking about. Keeps throwing me out of my shot. Still got him anyway. Take that. Man, I cannot wait to get my Widow. Wow. How did that not... Oh, well. Oh, son of... Really? That's a waste. Yeah, I didn't think I'd hit him with that either.
Taking heavy fire.
That's pretty costly misses right there. Gotcha. Let me go ahead and take the rest of that real quick. Why? Oh, how do you live with like one health point? Okay. Well, that's probably what they ask me a lot is, how are you alive with one health point? Just hanging on over here. I'll take that to the face. Is she back up? Okay, that's probably it then. Good deal. Let's look around for stuff. I'm going to be thorough here. I want to make sure I grab all the credits. These are essentially bonus credits, being a DLC, and I'm going to need every one of them.
The ramp, the bolt, sealed them in.
Damn it! We have to find another way.
Nothing? Really? It's been a while since I've been here, but... Well, I'm gonna trust my eyes. I don't see anything.
Glad that's over.
I know one of you guys will let me know if I miss something, so... Oh well. This is good for another 4 grand. Curious exactly what information is in this gray box thing that's got this Hawk guy. I mean, as much money and power as this dude has, if it's worth something to him, I'm guessing that it's worth like a lot. Like, say, maybe billions to the Shadow Broker type of information. Which is as much a commodity as biotics or tech or genetic research or any of that stuff. It's all money, you know, to these folks.
Taking cover.
Yeah, I already know they've got an ambush right here. Yep. Yeah, y'all aren't slick, man. I'll just fire away. Ouch. That didn't work. Okay, I don't need any more cheap hits on me. Unless I'm... Yeah, I was real close to it there. There we go. Ah. Okay. Damn it. Nice. I thought I saw a robot walk over here. One of those mechs didn't? It's not. Oh, really? Ah. Oh, that was horrible, miss. Alright. Got him. That made up for it. Yeah, they can't do much when they're being reaved.
I need targeting a
you need to target that. Alright, now there has to be some loot in here. Has to be. This is like a one-way trip. You don't get to come back here and look around later type of thing, so. Oh, 4,800. Wow. Okay. Nice. Totally worth it. That's basically a Mako right there, man.
That got it.
Miss my Mako. Well, they're doing a lot of dying. We're doing fine. Don't mind us. This dude's got a lot of hired hands, though. A lot of thugs working for him. Seriously. Alright, this is probably a good safe spot. That's what I think. That looks like a ledge you drop off and don't come back from. That's what that looks like. Yep. And I'm sure it's an ambush right here, too. Well, of course it is. You like that?
Here we go.
Need some cup.
Got it.
Knock that shield down. Oh, no. Let me down. Wow. That's what I'm talking. One hit point. Wow. I don't think you can get any closer to dying without dying. Yeah, once those missiles knock you back, they don't outright kill you. They open you up for a chaser with that minigun, and that's it. Taking that stuff to the face, too. Old Kasumi over there. Yeah, she's a little glitched, I think, or something. She should be in cover, but whatever. I'm the one getting fired at, pretty much. Actually, the mech's worried about me, and all those other guys seem to be worried about her. Get down and hide, girl.
Gotcha.
Seriously. Just support me with some overloads and stuff. SMG takes down some armor pretty quick, too. I mean, I know the pistol's supposed to punch through that, and it does amazing versus basic health, but, SMG's good for shield and armor. Yeah, it's just as effective as a pistol, in my opinion. His armor's melting away. Be nice to have some incendiary rounds right about now, or armor-piercing rounds. He'd be half dead already.
As you wish.
Yeah, enough of that. Nice. Kasumi didn't even go down during that. She took some hits, too. Alright. I'm not leaving until I get some loot out of this. Something. Take some ammo, too, by the way. Yeah, there we go. Give me that. See, it seems like I remember there being, like, salvage parts and stuff like that kind of laying everywhere. I don't know. Actually, I picked up a pretty decent amount of credits already. And since Cerberus has a tendency to match that, this ought to be pretty nice. So Kasumi gets her gray box. Uh-oh. Murderer.
As you wish.
She is awesome. Yeah, she gets her gray box. I can make a bunch of credits, get to get rid of some bad guys. As far as I'm concerned, that's kind of like getting paid in and of itself. All right, yeah, just get out of here. Got something to say to you. I wish Jacob was here to just pull her bitch ass out from behind there. Oh, well, never mind. She's coming anyway, isn't she?
There they are. You got it.
Oh, I hip. I quick scoped her. Oh, so close. Yeah, I'm not even going to waste another bullet on that bitch. There you go. Vanguards are nasty.
Let's
see. Can you overload that explosive crate, please? Didn't kill her? Really? Oh, that's supposed to... I was supposed to stun her. Wow. Oh, if that had killed me right there... Well, I'd have had it coming. Really. Yeah, I'd have deserved that one. No, you can't even get over there. There's got to be stuff here. Has to be. Notice the garage signs there like they had in Mass Effect 1. There's enough stuff left over from Mass Effect 1. I mean, the art style, it's unmistakably Mass Effect as far as that goes, but it's nice that they brought some stuff. Like, okay, we don't have the Mako, but you see them here still. Like, it's enough familiar things in the surroundings and the settings and stuff so you can kind of feel at home. They do really good about that. In Mass Effect 3, they get away from a few things, and they bring in some new things, but none of it seems out of place. It's all still really familiar. They do an amazing job with that. It's kind of hard when you're in a game series and you go from one to the next, and they're so different that it feels like a totally different game.
I'll take care of this myself.
Take care of this yourself, huh? What, you running out of henchmen? Alright, well, if you're gonna shoot me, I'm gonna get my shot in too. Got another Vanguard. Okay. She's charging. I forgot how aggressive they are.
Mind over matter.
No, I'm wanting to hit the Vanguard. Why is it? Whatever. Okay.
There we are.
I can do some work to a barrier, man. I'm not overly impressed with Reeve on armor. It says it does double damage to armor, but I'm like, double damage as opposed to what? You know. But to barriers and health? Oh, it's amazing. Oh! Okay, that was nice. Yeah, that cloak damage bonus is beautiful. Once I max it out, oh man. Then you're straight assassin. All these would be one shots. They wouldn't necessarily even need to be headshots all the time. Alright, I guess we'll do kind of a clockwise sweep. Did I see something right here in this corner? It's not. Oh, okay, there it is. All right. Walk right by it. Nothing, though. Yeah, I hate that nagging feeling that I'm missing something. Like, missing something big. Like, some stuff that I'm gonna wish I had later type thing, or... I just don't like missing stuff, period, really. As long as I know where it's at. Or as long as I know where it should be. Oh, well. I think I got it all. Usually, even from a distance, you can see things register. If you still have something to find. Usually. Alright, I think this is it. Shielded gunship and another army. Awesome. Wow, okay, well, that was almost over real fast. I need to increase the cooldown on her overload. So Overlord's a great multi-purpose tool. It's just... be nice if it could be used a little bit more often. Wow.
Lay down your weapons.
I'm gonna get some shots in on this bitch. Got missiles too, huh? Alright. You don't really have much time to whittle away at them between waves. Oh, wow. What a waste. Could you overload him, please? That'd be great. Go get him. That's what you do. She has a tendency to wander, doesn't she? We gotta get his shields down the first time. On our own. And then I think the second wave is then you actually get to deal with his arm or something like that. There you go. Now this locust will tear down a shield quick. Yeah, I think this was a good call. Disruptor ammo, especially on rapid fire weapons, right? And then keep the Reeve for basically everything else. Okay. Get him? Ooh, ooh, ooh. Ouch. There we go. Got him. Okay, I'm not gonna lie, this next part, the very first time I ever fought this fight, this next part right here, I was like, wow, really? What the hell does it take? I'm really glad they don't have any vanguards out here. That would be nasty. Got him. Alright. Got a few pieces of ammo just laying around. I'll take that. Yeah, and then he gets it all back, and I'm like, we did all that for nothing? Seriously?
If I can get to the ship, I can take down the shield.
Believe it or not, I found the mechs to be the most dangerous thing here because they'll charge you. They have no problem with walking right up into your face. When you're dealing with all this other stuff, it's... Yeah. Finish that one off, would you please? There you go. Nice. Do you? Well, you can't fly all of them, bitch. You can only fly them one at a time. And I fully intend to blow you up in that thing. Blow it up with you in it. That's right. That's the plan, anyway. Ah, I had to finish off that mech. Just had to. Yeah, that was close. There you go. Thank you. How's that feel? Those Salarians, man, they're tough. They're not quite a Turian, but close.
Too late to get out of this alive, Kasumi.
There we go. Yeah, you can waste all your ammo on his second shield. You can just waste it. Because basically you just have to clear that last wave to get her to do this. And then she turns into an absolute ninja. She's so... Man, it's such a good job with this character. And she's not a romance option. So you can't have any actual choice dialogue with her. It's a shame. Still, probably the most rewarding or the best DLC character that I can really think of.
Shields down. Let's tear that thing apart.
All right, I'm gonna wait for reinforcements first. I believe we can just straight up kill him now. Yeah. Yeah, there we go. That's what I was waiting on. Let's get them out of the way, then we can take a few pot shots at him and wash, rinse, and repeat until he's dead. Man, this Locust is just a killer all-around weapon. It really is. Back. Alright, focus on him for a second.
No one escapes from Donovan the Hock.
Look straight ahead.
Alright. get a bunch of rounds back per clip that you pick up. No. We don't need you going out there right now. This is not the time. There we go. Alright. Once you know they're not charging you, it takes a little of the pressure off. Knowing they're creeping up on you though, that's, yeah. Get my health back. Okay, I think we can lay into him a little bit now. It's on insanity. Some of the enemies are just so damn tanky, you know?
They're coming from the front.
There we go. Get the hell out of here. Yeah, I guess we get more people. Yeah. I think I missed. Okay, well, you'll be getting out of there. Nice. How is it not dead? That was a stealth shot too. Oh, you're out of there. You're out of there, dude. Yeah, you're out of there. That's right. Here comes the Normandy. Now, I seriously remember there being another health thing around here. You know, first aid kit thingy. Somewhere around here in the square. I guess one that you could pick up during the fight in a pinch or something if you really needed it. Whatever. It's 100 credits to me. So I don't think we've used any. I try to stay full on those. Best I can. I expect to use actually a few of them when we go to get our next squad member. I expect to. Maybe not. Maybe we'll do well, but most likely we'll run into a little bit of trouble. It can be kind of nasty. Let's see what's in this thing.
Kasumi, if you're seeing this, it's because I'm dead. The information we found is all here. It's big, Kasumi. If the Council ever got wind of this, the Alliance could be implicated. Kasumi, I encrypted the information to keep it safe. And I uploaded the encryption key to your Greybox. So no one could get the whole package. But if I'm dead, and if anyone knows about this, then I've made you a target, my love. I'm so, so sorry.
Keiji.
I know you, Kasumi. You'll want to keep these memories forever. But you don't need some neural implant to know I'll always be with you. Please, Kasumi. Destroy these files. There's nothing more I can do to protect you.
I can't do that. This is all that's left.
Goodbye, Kasumi. I love you.
Is there any way we can just destroy the information?
No. Keiji's a master at encrypting files. He laced the information into his memories. You can't get one without experiencing the other.
If it's that important to you, keep it. Just make sure you're ready to live with the consequences.
Yeah, I am. I'll stay off the grid. No one will know I exist. think I want this. Thanks, Shepard.
Now, that actually, it came across as like maybe a moral choice or one of those things like, uh-oh, should I, shouldn't I? There's really no question in my mind. That's not my stuff. That's her stuff. I have no say on that. That's a pretty basic rule of life. Your stuff is not my stuff. If I take your stuff, I'm stealing it. I have nothing to say about your stuff. That's not my business. You know, I helped her get it as a favor in exchange for her service on our mission here, which she probably would have done anyway. And honestly, I probably would have helped her anyway. Not only do I think she's cool and hot and all that good stuff, but I got to go kill some bad guys and I got paid. I got, what, 60,000 credits. I mean, I'm just saying, and a really cool gun. You know, I'd have done that regardless. But that box, that's hers. That she owns that. It's not my place to say anything on that. I'm totally out of line even speaking on that. You know? And I'll tell you what, if there's information that it can implicate the Alliance, then they shouldn't have done whatever they did. See, covering up dirt doesn't make the dirt go away. It just adds more dirt to the dirt. You think you're sweeping it under the rug. Well, no, you're not. You're just sweeping the dirt under more dirt. Because anytime you lie about something, well, that's not the truth. And so, you know, maybe if the Alliance did something, maybe they need to pay for that, pay those consequences. And, you know, I don't know, Alliance Council and all that, it all just smells of Cerberus to me anyway, as far as any of that goes, so I don't know. Political scandal, economic scandal, social scandal stuff, that shit's a dime a dozen. It's all day, every day. There's no new thing under the sun. It's been done a million times, you know what I'm saying? So there's nothing so important in that box that won't happen again tomorrow by some other government official, or won't happen again next week by some other military group. You know what I'm saying? It's irrelevant.
I heard that those lakes up on the Presidium are filled with fish.
No, they're not.
You ever been up there?
No. CSEC won't let me. They say I'm a risk.
They think every Krogan is dangerous.
Damn Turians. We should kill them all.
I wonder why they think you're dangerous. We should kill them all. Damn Turians. All right, well,
this should come in
thanks
handy.
To Donovan Hock, I now have enough money to upgrade my stuff. Can't wait to get another sniper upgrade. That'd be nice.
Then I can do for you?
I noticed you're one of the groundskeepers for the Presidium. Do you know if there are fish in the lakes?
I get that question a lot. I think it's right behind where's the restroom. Those are reservoirs, the Presidium's own supply, independent from the water storage tanks in the wards. The only place I know of on the station to get a live fish is Delea Sonnesi's gift shop.
Where is that gift shop?
In the market downstairs from the bar. Delea sells aquariums. Fish are the largest pets most station residents can get a permit for.
When I pour a glass of water, it's the same stuff tourists throw garbage in.
No, they purify it first. If some Solarian or human bacteria gets left in, and a Turian or Quarian drinks it, they could die. Everything would be so much simpler if we all had the same DNA. But no, the universe loves diversity.
Thanks for your time.
No problem. If you get up to the Presidium, check out the Demile flowers across from the conduit. They're coming in very nicely.
Huh, they'll still call that the conduit? But they don't acknowledge the Reapers. We said Saren was looking for the conduit for a reason. Everybody almost got killed because of it. And they'll still acknowledge that, but they... Wow. Okay. Shouldn't be surprised, right?
What do you want?
Why are you so interested in fish from the Presidium?
It's so decadent. Eating a fish from the Presidium would be like... screwing Shaira.
Sorry, you're so squishy. Where are you supposed to get a decent grip?
I ever heard you talking about the fish on the Presidium.
What, you mean there actually are some?
Sure, I just caught one. I have it with me now.
I'll pay you for it.
What, you don't think I'm hungry? I went all the way up to the Presidium for this. Why should I give it to a random Krogan?
I'll pay you a lot for it.
It's obvious you really want it. Here you go.
Weren't you saving that money for a new gun?
Who cares? They wouldn't let me use it here anyway. Thank you, human. Many Krogan must have dreamed of this day, but I get to be the first.
It's just a damn fish. Guns are better than fish.
Okay. I know, taking advantage of the poor Krogan. I thought it was funny. Okay, now, besides that, I remembered something about that. I was wondering if it was in the next act or section of the game or this one. I couldn't remember, but I'm glad I caught them. And then I need to return this this data pad we found when we were rescuing Garrus, that exposes all the different merc gangs as wanting to take over Arya's turf and all that stuff. Five possible weapon upgrades, and I can't use any of them right now. Alright, I need to go find some things. And then, from here... Actually, I think Arya's gonna give us another little... Yeah, she gives us a bonus mission. And then I think we'll go recruit our next squad member. Sounds good to me.
Datapad was on one of the mercs going after Archangel. They were coming for you next. Let me see. Interesting. Would someone like to tell me how this information slipped the net?
I'll look into it.
You've done a lot for me, Shepard. Let me return the favor. We're sending your coordinates to a cache on an uncharted world. You want it? It's yours.
What's the catch?
No catch. I don't need it, and I don't want it to go to waste. Whatever you find is yours to deal with.
Thanks. Maybe I'll come back later.
You should find a nice young man to keep you warm in the meantime. You look like you need to loosen up.
No, maybe you need to find yourself a man. You need to get a man, Arya. Now, let's see, Arya. Let's go figure. You've got Batarians under you, working with you. You're trusting Batarians. Okay. That's just mistakes all the way across the board. And you're doing favors. Or you're... Okay, well, in a Batarian's eyes, not killing a human is doing them a favor by not killing them. So anything besides killing humans, torturing and then killing, enslaving, torturing and killing humans is doing them a favor, is being nice to them in their eyes. And so seeing as... you helped us along getting Archangel and getting Morden, and a lot of Batarians died in the process, along with Vorch and stuff like that. It's possible that your people have turned on you accordingly. That may be what's going on there, Arya. Not too hard to figure out. Surprised you didn't see that coming. And it's like... But yeah,
I have found something.
If you hire Batarians, whatever you get, well, you're kind of asking for that anyway. Showing them pity, mercy, or tolerance, get your throat cut. Unequivocally.
Yeah.
Won't be going that way.
It is likely that searching the wreckage would provide information about the Estevanico's final hours. Warning, disturbing the wreck could cause it to become unbalanced and fall over the cliff's edge.
If I think about it later, it might be worth looking into the codex once we discover what's up with this wreck, why it's here, and so on and so forth. This is pretty cool. This was like totally different. You know, you expect to get ambushed by gangs, mobbed by Geth or something, you know, and you wind up getting to, it's kind of like a puzzle, sort of. With the whole idea of being thousands of feet in the air, teetering on the edge of a cliff, that's makes this interesting. Okay, well, I think I'm pushing 400,000 or 500,000 iridium. I've got a lot of iridium. I'm turning iridium down on some of these planets so as not to waste probes on it, type of thing. And so I don't think I need these little mini caches here, unless it's giving me money too. At the same time, then I'll take it, sure. So, whose ship was this? Was this a human ship, or...? It looks old, at least by Mass Effect standards. Be futuristic to us, but, you know, compared to... Or this has just been here a long time, or else it went through something horrific. I wonder if it got sawn in half by a Reaper like the Normandy did, or something. Like I say, it might be worth looking at the Codex and see if there's any hint as to what might have happened with this thing. Now that I'm thinking about it. I don't think this would just be a random little bonus side mission just out of the blue for no reason. Okay, well, I know that's the end where the blinking light is. Before I get to some point of no return, let me go. I'm gonna go back over here and look for a second. Like I said, I'm not really worried about boxes of iridium, but there may be some credits laying around. We definitely want those. We're gonna need a bunch of money when we go to recruit the Krogan. Nope, this just takes me back down there. Yeah, okay. Alright, sorry about that. Just had to see. Back off in this corner. Just curious. The way these plates are dropping down, you walk a little too far and something drops behind you and you can't turn back. Seeing if any more little boxes of refine. I see one there. At least one more. My guess is if this is a Cerberus thing. Cerberus enter this, then it has to have something to do with the collectors or the Reapers, right? It almost has to. Or else they really wouldn't care about it. And they would know more about it than what they would tell you. And then they would completely lie to you, telling you why they're having you go look at it. I mean, you know, it's just all standard MO for them. Well, hey, I don't know who's still here. But I have a question. Don't know how many people will see this. I know a lot of the really longer videos it takes a certain crowd to sit in a video more than 5 minutes. Seems like, but whatever. I know those of you that really like these games like to hang out and stuff and have nothing else, just chill. Grab a bag of popcorn or bag of Doritos or something, just chill. But I was thinking of looking into one obscure game. It's pretty obscure, and I don't know how much of a let's play. It's got a lot of content. It's huge. It's bigger than a couple of these RPGs put together. You could take Skyrim and this and Fallout and Dragon Age, any one of the Dragon Age games, and put them all together, and it's still, this game would probably be bigger than that. It's Divinity 2. It's really cool. Beautiful soundtrack and stuff like that. The graphics are okay. It's a beautiful game. Maybe not graphics-wise, you know, it's not, you know, HD-type stuff or whatever, but it's an older game. Not so old that it still doesn't look... I don't know. Anyway, it doesn't matter. It's a really cool game. It's got a great story to it. Was thinking about doing... I missed the game, and it's really just for me, I guess. But if anyone would be interested in that, I would guess that as much of an under-the-radar game as it was, as amazing of an RPG as it was... Oh, wow. Talk about the nick of time. Yeah, when they were still making spaceships with wings like that, I'm going to guess that's a very old ship. So those of you that know the lore about that are probably going, oh, well, it's just such and such. But I don't, so I'm going to go probably take a look at that if I think about it later. Yeah, but anyway, it's just one of those neat games that should have been really, really popular and famous and didn't grab the attention. People still play it. Still play it today. So, anyway, just a thought. I don't want to put too many irons in the fire. Oh, this one. Yeah, this is the one Arya sent us to. Basically, it's a cache. You deal with whatever you deal with when you get there, and whatever you find, you can keep it. I can see why she didn't want to come mess with this, though. Maybe she honestly didn't have time, or she really didn't feel like messing with three friggin' giant mechs.
Understood. Taking cover!
Well, I'm not going to draw all their aggro at once. That's a way to save a few more crates, and it's also a way to get yourself destroyed. Well, while they're over there having a field day destroying our shit. Yeah, if you can draw a threat from all three and get them all over here at the same time, then you can save most if not all of your crates. I'm not that worried about it. I don't know if there's some kind of special bonus or something for saving all of them. I don't know. Probably. But I'm just going to have to miss that, I guess. But when they're incapacitated, they take some real damage.
Attacking target.
Okay, well, at least he's not busy destroying crates. That third one is, though, somewhere over there. Acting bad on our stuff.
This is...
Ouch. Yeah, look at the extra damage when they're down. That is crazy. So I'm guessing overload? Stacked? Overload stacked? Disabled them essentially? And that just... But I imagine the shields and armor have to both be down already. Okay, that's nice. I forgot some of those powers in the third and fourth rank start to pick up extra bonus debuffs and stuff. Clink, clink, clink. You can hear the bullets bouncing off it.
This is slowing down.
All right. No. Here, we go ahead and finish him off. Well, like I say, he's not, if he'd laid into me instead with that gun right there, I'd be dead.
It's gonna blow!
Uh-oh. Yeah, we need to stay way away from that. Man, they nuke when they go off. see where they got the idea for the legendary robots in Fallout 4. That just literally... Talk about nukes. They set off nukes like the nukes that destroyed the city in the first place. Those kind of nukes. I've been on the other side of buildings when those things died anyway. Like, really? Someone kills a protector on five rooms away, down the hallway, clear on the other side of the building. Still die. Alright, so that's cool. I thought we'd take care of this too. Just clean up little side missions and stuff. There'll be a few more like this along the way. I'll kind of throw them in there, but mainly I wanted to get Kasumi's loyalty mission done. Like I said, I'd have done that for her anyway. Even if she was already loyal or whatever, or if it didn't matter. I still helped her with that. We got rid of some real bad guys and a bunch of their cronies. I mean, we took out that dude and basically his whole squad with it. Would have been nice to leave some kind of booby trap behind in his house. That'd have been the plan. You leave a booby trap upstairs, get down there into the vault or whatever, and if you know there's a back door out, leave another way, and then trigger that stuff to go off and take out a lot of people's problems. See, that guy's like, well, people need us, you know, to keep their lives luxurious and all that, you know, and they like the false sense of peace and stuff, thinking that the wheels are just going round and round. And I said, well, okay, there is a certain lascivious quality to people, maybe, you know, people enjoying the benefits of the underground, the black market and stuff like that and whatever, but the victims of your crimes, the people who pay the price for you doing all the things you do to get the things that you get and provide what you provide, they have a different view on the criminals, okay? Their view is, you know, these criminals are responsible for taking their sons and daughters and wives and parents and their lives and stuff, okay? They're not real keen on that. Enslaving their people, their family and stuff. Yeah, not cool. I guess it just depends on who you talk to. For me, all those bad guys just need to go. The easy way, where it doesn't cost the taxpayers anything but the cost of a couple bullets. No big deal. And make the galaxy a much better place, right? Alright, well, let's go do some more recruiting. That's what I say. We're just around the corner. Let's go get the convict. I think that's next. And that's where I will pick up it. That's where I will pick it up with you guys on the next one. I appreciate you guys hanging out. Well, it's been a long one. It's always a lot of fun, at least for me anyway. Alright, if you want to subscribe, you haven't already, you can click the button up top. And if you want to catch Mass Effect 1 playthrough, you can click the top box there. And if you want to catch the rest of this Let's Play from the beginning, you can click the bottom one. Alright, y'all take care. Appreciate you hanging out. I'll catch you guys later. Bye-bye.